So click on the tab, the default is wall. And if you don't see interface, go to the top of the list, you will see interface. All right. So now we have two interfaces. The next step, we're going to tell Fluent, these two, they are the same face. Because if it's a wall, we need to specify what is boundary condition. Is this adiabatic? Is this convection? Is it temperature? We don't know. At the interface, who knows what the temperature is? All the convection, we don't know anything. But the solver should take care of this itself. But we need to tell the solver, this is the interface between my fluid domain and my solid domain, and this should be part of the solution. We are not going to specify anything because we don't know anything. We don't know the temperature, we don't know flux, we don't know anything. So here, after we do that, you will see this option pops up. It says mesh interfaces. Click on that. Mesh interfaces, we're going to create one. Create. All right, let's give it a name. Let's call it bulb, air box interface. Whatever name you want. All right, so one of them is air box face. The other one must be, if you choose air box bulb, then here you choose bulb face. All right, make sure they're different. And make sure you check this box, coupled wall. This is Fluent, how Fluent handles interfaces. If you specify this coupled wall, Fluent will understand, okay, this is part of the solution. Nothing needs to be specified. Create. Again, give it a name. One of the faces, the other one. Controls, equations, yes, we're going to solve flow and energy. Okay. Monitors, we're going to monitor the residuals. Of course, you can also monitor the temperature, or the temperature. But here, let's start with the residuals. Calculate solution initialization, click on that. We need to do that. Initialize, something says. Hybrid initialization is done. So look at the text here. Run the calculation. Let's give it 300. Let's see what happens. 300 iterations. We're going to run this. Calculate. Nothing happens. Click again.